Hello. My name is Dr. Leti Gutierrez-Lopez, and I am happy to welcome you to this episode of 3 to Thrive. Today, I'm going to provide you some tips on how to manage stress while working. The first tip is to find an activity that will relax your body and mind. For example, schedule time for walks while at work. According to Psychology Today, walking is great for your brain. It can boost your energy, stimulate your creativity, and reduce anxiety, among many other benefits. Have you ever considered going for a walk and talk? Most people report feeling a sense of calm when they get back to their workspace after a walk. Some other relaxing activities at work may include trying aromatherapy, stretching, walking over to the water station to enjoy some fresh water, listening to calming music, eating a healthy snack, stepping away from the computer, engaging in deep belly breathing in your nose and out your mouth, or meditation. And the list of relaxing activities can go on. I encourage you to create a list of at least 3 things you can do at work, and remember to schedule them in wherever you can. The second tip is to practice gratitude. In positive psychology research, gratitude is strongly and consistently associated with greater happiness. Gratitude helps people feel more positive emotions, relish good experiences, improve their health, deal with adversity, and build strong relationships. What are you grateful for? Who are you grateful for? Do they know it? Can you identify 3 good things today that you are grateful for? If you feel comfortable, close your eyes and think of them. How does that make you feel? You might want to consider a virtual gratitude jar in the workplace. Create a tab in your Teams group and label it gratitude jar. Folks can add statements of gratitude there, and at your next all-staff meeting, lunch, or other event, take turns reading them all off and see how that makes everyone feel. The third tip, while not as easy to do at work, is essential for everyone's well-being, and that is to get plenty of sleep. Experts recommend enjoying at least 8 hours per night of uninterrupted sleep. The practice of developing healthy sleep habits, sleep hygiene, is important to ensuring a good night's sleep. Consider taking some actions during your workday to improve your sleep quality. These can include reducing caffeine intake, drinking plenty of water, and getting some exercise. Remember tip number 1, that walk can reduce stress while helping you prep for a good night's sleep. Good sleep hygiene habits can also include engaging in relaxing activities at bedtime, such as reading or meditation before falling asleep. Have you ever tried progressive muscle relaxation? You might want to Google it and see how it goes. And one other good sleep hygiene habit to consider is reducing the bright sources of light and noise and putting your phone on Do Not Disturb while you sleep. I hope these tips are helpful. Remember to relax, express gratitude, and get your Z's. Thank you for tuning in. Take care and be well, Cal Poly.